Hi, this is Bridget with Matside TV. Don't forget to watch and follow us on Matside YouTube TV. Yes.
The year was 1907. The Cubs won the World Series and the Ford Model R hit the assembly line. While here in Ohio, school administrators came together to form the Ohio High School Athletic Association. One thing that hasn't changed since 1907 is the dedication of the OHSAA to education-based athletics in Ohio. School sports teach responsibility, sportsmanship, and life lessons that stay with students long after their playing days are over. The OHSAA seeks to prepare students not for the next level of sport, but for the next level of life.
They call him the bull rep.
Please congratulate for the year 2024, the OHSA Extinct Wrestling Finalists.
Thank you.
Making her 28th appearance at the state wrestling finals, Diane Stapleton Robinson retired after teaching English for 35 years in Fairfield High School in Fairfield, Ohio. She began performing national anthem professionally in 1971 with the U.S. Air Force Band at the Grand American Trap Shoot in Vandalia, Ohio. She has sung at the International Coca-Cola Collectors Club and numerous athletic events throughout the state since 1988. But the state wrestling tournament is one of her favorites, singing with 16,000 members of the Ohio High School wrestling family.
Join me. Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleam, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, on the rocket's red glare, the bones bursting in air, gave proof through the night that a flag was oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of love.
Here we go, John. This is the culmination of 2023, 2024, and it doesn't get any better than tonight.
That's right. Coach, these young men have gone from this time last year all the way through summer wrestling. They've done miles and miles on the road. They've done the weight rooms. They've gone all season long just to get to this spot, the state championship, mano-a-mano, number one, number two. These guys have made it all the way through the tournament. Champions are being crowned in every weight class tonight.
Yep, and at the end of the day, only one person in each weight class will get his hand raised. So here we go.
And we go. All right, Coach, we start Division One at the 106-pound weight class. We've got Aiden Dodd from Perrysburg. He's in your all-black singlet. He's going against Brandon Bickerton from Medina Highland.
There are some big 106-pounders, buddy.
Well, when you get here, weigh-ins were a while ago. They don't have to weigh in for another year now, so good underhook here by Dodd.
Gets his head on the right side, which
absolutely
is big.
Whoa! Dickerson got...
There's two.
Dickerson, the first takedown.
Yeah, Bickerton scores, so...
So, yeah, the...
All right, so back on our feet again. Minute 16 to go.
Dodd's a sophomore. 35-5 coming into the tournament. And oh, he's got that cradle.
Oh, he's got locked tight, too.
So he's got a roll over his back, right, Coach?
No rolls, buddy. There you go. He gets the two. Makes a whole different ball game now.
He's up 3-2. 50 seconds to go.
Nice movement by both kids. It's a guess when you've wrestled this many times, I'm betting they wrestled at sectionals too. Look at that nice post to leg, and Bickerton was ready on the way down. Looks like
Bickerton did a nice job jamming.
Yeah. Okay, 30 seconds to go, and if he can get away here, it'll be a whole new ball game going into second period.
Like
20 seconds to go. The score is 4-4.
Will we start?
Bickerton needs to move in. So,
both scores, I think Don probably needs to. He's doing a really good job, but he's been. Bickerton's scores have all come off of just, you know, getting out of position and Dodd getting himself a little out of position, right?
The flurries that we talk about.
Right. He's kind of, you know, put Dodd on his rear a couple of times just in a scramble situation.
All right, Dodd then defers, and Bickerton takes down, and we start the second period all tied up 4-4.
Good first moves by Bickerton.
Hand control and
for the lift
nice again. Lift. I like how Bickerton's using his legs and he's blocking behind the ankle. That was a nice trip.
Yeah. Got to have multiple. Oh, there you go again. Same thing. He's got to work up.
Yeah.
Keep working up.
There you go.
Nice job. Nice ride.
Yeah, that was good. Got 30 seconds gone in the second period.
That's marking under.
And
so I tell you,
out of down.
Seen so, you know, so far, Dodd appears to be the more offensive wrestler and the better rider of the two. Now, Bickerton is a freshman, so may not quite have the mat time, but we don't know these days. You know, these
guys have
a lot of time in the summers and earlier in their life. Minute left. Roll attempt, switch attempt. Got a lift here. Bickerton's done a nice job sagging his hips.
Yep.
To make that lift difficult. Dodd's got that cross face. Tough here because if you get yourself out of bounds.
Yeah, you got to keep him in if he's going to run that series.
It's good. Pulled up an arm bar but lost it on the far side.
They may be looking at Dodd in terms of stalling because he locked that ankle behind there with his leg. See how he's doing that? 15 seconds to go.
Well, he's got that.
Got that wing,
sure
that bar. Yeah.
He's got to stay perpendicular there.
That's a good ride there.
That was a great ride.
Yep. So.
You took that point away from.
Right.
Because Bickerton chooses a down position.
Yeah. Well, Dodd's going in.
Well, if we've seen anything from the first two times that Bickerton's been on top, Dodd has gotten out very fast both times.
Inside stand up.
And there we go again.
Less than three seconds, he's out. So now we're back on our feet where we started. And
now, Coach, does your strategy change if you're Dodd here? You're up by one. You're in the third period.
Well,
do you come at it as strong, or are you more...
No, I think you stay aggressive. You just don't take a bad shot. You know, I think what he needs to do is he's in control, and so one good shot and he knows he's up by big points. So, you know,
I like those ties right there, but you get that.
See, and again, they must have wrestled a lot because they know he's going to duck under to that opposite side. Minute 20.
This is going to be who can beat who to the spot because a couple of times Bickerton has beat Dodd to the spot, but other than that, Dodd's really been in control.
Watch your right elbow.
Elbows are down. Everything's down.
Yes. We're getting
down to a minute. Yep.
Bickerton's got to start with some attacks, right? Oh, Bickerton gets hit with stalling. I think that's okay because we have seen a number of series in a row where he's backed out. There's the offensive attack by Bickerton.
Well, and he caught Dodd off guard the last time and basically bowled it over like we had talked about.
Okay, there. Nice. Yep. The double. He's going to come up with it. Now we're in a scramble situation. Bickerton's been better both times so far in these scrambles. Let's see if Dodd can finish this.
He needs to pop his left arm around the waist to score. I think Bickerton's looking for a stalling call here.
He's going to try to stall.
Or not a stalling call, but a stalemate.
You're not in that much trouble if you're Dodd, so you got 18 seconds.
Oh, yeah.
You get a restart. You're up 5-4, 15 seconds. You haven't been hit for stalling, coach. I think you're posting, right?
Yeah.
Post and move.
And that's what the coaches are saying. Stay head-to-head.
Gets in that
12 seconds.
He's really put that chest on top of Bickerton's head. He's going to make it tough for him to do anything there.
4 seconds.
Three.
Whoa.
Oh, man. We'll have to see if it happened during in time or if it even was control.
Wow.
One coach.
We'll have to see that on slow-mo.
One coach.
Watch out.
One coach.
But my goodness. Desperation move work at the end for Bickerton if this holds. But it looks like it's going to because he's just explaining why he made the call as opposed to...
Ron,
Kelly and Ron, okay. Ron and Kelly. Ron, Joseph, Kelly still are the officials, okay. So you have Burnett coming up. At 113 for Perrysburg, going to be in the black and gold again. He's going against St. Ed.
St. Ed.
Timer.
And St. Ed's have 7 in the finals, so this will be interesting.
Timer is a junior. Last year he was state champ at 106, so moving up a weight class.
Yeah.
He's going against Burnett. Burnett's a freshman.
On that number two, boys division.
And there they come.
A 32-6 record from Lakewood St. Edward. Returning state champion, junior, Ethan Teamer.
Ethan Teamer. All right.
So last week, we looked at the districts. They were at the Perrysburg district. Teamer beat Burnett in the finals of the districts. And so once again, they meet again.
Another rematch. Yep. Well, I'll tell you, the future looks really good for Perrysburg. But, you know, the first 4 kids are all back next year. Remember the 20-pounder lost a tough one in the semi.
Right.
And he was an underclassman.
All right, so our head official here is Ron Joseph. Kelly Stillman's the mat judge.
You know, it would really be interesting to be in Perrysburg's practice room with those first 4 weight classes. I'll bet there's some real scrapping going on there.
So, Coach, you know you've got to be watching if you're, you know, just being the wrestling partner. You're aware of your wrestling partner's match, right? What's that do here with that just at the very end? That last match with Dodd losing in the last seconds. What's that do to start for Burnett here?
Yeah, well, again, one of 2 things happen. We know that. Either you're fired up and you're angry and you don't want to let that same thing happen to you, or you use it and you psychologically it puts you down, especially if you guys are really good friends too, like I'm sure they are.
All right, Burnett's first on the attack here. Again, Burnett,
he got to get his head on the other side, though, or he's going to be He got an underhook that side, and
yeah, Teamer tried to jump over and get that long leg. Really good scramble from both guys here. Man, Teamer hit that leg.
Yeah, he did. No points yet.
Wow, so that's very different. It's what happens to get different officiating. The last official, yeah, they lost a match on a much more questionable whether they had control. This one, I thought Teamer had control.
Yeah.
It was 0-2. The last match didn't look like Bickerton had control, but they gave it to him. So we change the officials each match. That's
yeah,
part of it.
Well, got 8 seconds to go, so it was an interesting first period.
That was a heck of a scramble.
Yeah, that was.
Golden points. And now we've got...
Oh, he takes down.
Burnett takes down.
I find it interesting the number of matches Timo wrestled, you know, 35 to 43. Oh, there's that single leg you were talking about going down to there.
Oh, so that's got to be, it's coming up. All right, got 8 game.
That was good hustle on Burnett's part.
Trip move. Oh, there's a good.
Ah.
Man, look at that scramble.
Yep.
He's got to hold on for dear life there.
Whoa, what about his own back?
Burnett. In the scramble, can he get turned around? Can he get the leg out? He's trying to reach back and peel it off. There, he's trying to stand up on that.
Yeah, it's tough.
Yes.
So you got 1:05 to go here.
Good hand control by Burnett. Teamer gets the, oh wow, does a cartwheel. He almost out. I think he got a hit. Man, he got it.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's
close.
Yeah, it is close, 49 seconds. I think.
What happens one or two more times, it's gonna be hit for Stalling. You gotta think, right?
I would think. I think Burnett's initiating all the action on the bottom.
See the turn in again. So he comes up, gotta have the hand.
Yeah,
he gets it. Gets out, but
there's the point.
This is one.
That was big. I like how he stayed forehead to forehead, but you know, he's taking that rush in, that two. Are we going to get a Merkle?
You got a Merkle. You think he'll get over? Has he got control? No legs yet. Got to get the legs in. There's control right there. That's two.
That's two.
Now wow. 3 points.
With 12 seconds to go. That's, he's got it tight, too. I don't think he's going to get back points.
That's That's big.
Very big. 3 points on into the last period.
We went through the whole first period with not, one flurry, not much scoring attempts. And
let's see. Oh, he's sitting on his ankles. I haven't seen that one yet.
I'm guessing a sit out. Not really, no slow sit out. Coming up with control. And that's plot. All right.
Here we are scrambling again.
This could be a reverse. This looks tough.
Well, you got to get his head up. There you go. Give up the one.
Two, smart wrestling there.
Yeah. If you're going to use that 2-on-1, you got to get his head over on the other side. You know, Timo's doing the right thing. You push the head away if you're doing that.
Yeah, absolutely. Right call by the officials. See, backed out. That's a textbook stall.
So you got a minute 24 left here. Now, as long as Burnett stays in the middle on circles, he's in good shape.
Well, we haven't seen Timar actually come on an attack.
Yeah.
The offense has come from Burnett.
So right.
He could just, again, circle and pokes, right? Because you put yourself, that's what happened with Dodd. He, you know, he went for a shot attempt at the end. And
yeah.
You just stay away.
Come on, roll your head over
you
again.
You don't want to stay away too much, but. Pretty quick stall call there, but I guess I understand.
Yeah, he backed up. See how they lock that up? I find that interesting. Nice shot.
Wow.
39 seconds.
My point is tough. Is this Burnett has been the one initiating everything the entire match, and the first time he backs up, he gets hit with stalling. I don't know. That just doesn't sit well with me, given the match.
So he got to roll his head over on the other side, bro.
Does he get it?
Hips up.
That's it. Did he hit it? No points.
20 seconds to go.
So at this point.
17.
If you're Burnett. Yeah, that's point. That's the ball right there. It's got to be, yeah.
Whoa. How is that red? Whoa. How does that happen?
That's just terrible officiating. That's terrible officiating.
Four.
I think
three,
he actually did
two,
the wrong thing.
One.
He meant to hit forever. Wow. Wrestlers don't lie, I guess. I called on lie in this case. I really think Ron, you used the wrong hand in that situation because T-Mark backed all the way out and he hit the wrong guy foot. So I really think it was.
Alright, so we got 120. Carson Brown from St. Ed's, again in the, I guess it's dark green, looks black.
Yeah.
And he's going against Garrison Weisner from Oregon Clay. We'll see, hopefully this is a green singlet, but no, it's black also with gold trim. So I guess we'll look at the shoes. Weisner has got the blue shoes.
Yes, he does.
And Brown has the white shoes, so.
So I'm going to guess these guys wrestled before at semis.
And the Perrysburg districts?
Yeah.
Probably, right? Because they were first and third out of Perrysburg.
Yeah.
Last year, Brown is a returning state champ as a sophomore, so he won it as a freshman last year at 113. Weisner was fourth last year at 113.
Yeah, so they've definitely wrestled each other a few times. They're both pretty big, strong 120 pounders.
All right, Weisner gets to the leg.
He just muscled his way in there.
Yeah, picked that up. Everything going so
far. Here we
so
go.
Good. We'll see about the funkiness.
Freestyle stuff.
And Weisner's scrambling to try to make sure. No points here, but there's two and back points
and
now.
And back. Well, that's big. 11 seconds to go. That was big.
Oh, wow. Look, we're going to have potential back points here. We've seen this armbar series a lot this year, but,
yeah.
this with the hips, that's what makes the turn, is loading those hips up.
Oh, we got 50 seconds. I misread that clock.
So now we're 8-0 in favor of
8-0. I don't think I'd got second period if it was my choice if I was Garrison Weisner taken down.
They've got to get the first move here. Does Weisner to get out.
Okay, Carson Brown.
Yeah. agree with that call.
Yeah.
You can't come up on the back of those legs like that, and you know, that's illegal. So, you know, you can throw legs in. You can do a lot of things there that's potentially dangerous, but that's not. That's, so now 8-1. Eisner continuing to try to get away. Good job by Brown to climb up. Brown comes down again.
17 seconds.
Oh, now we got a chance at the... Now we got the scramble again.
Yeah, good
this
Lord.
This time Eisner's on this. Can he make the? Can he make the two before the time? There's 2 seconds, and he gets. Oh, he gets the two right at the end.
At the end there.
Yeah. So now it's
8-3
to end of the period. So St. Ed's coach is asking about locking hands, and
the
official saying, "Hey, you have to allow for reaction time," which he did. So we move on to the second period. They've got a score in there, 8-3 in the first. Brown gets the option to take the down position.
He takes down, so both big, strong 20-pounders, man.
Well, that is off, Coach. When you get from, you know, districts to states to placing to champions, all good. Power is a big differentiator, right? You talk about these kids being big, strong. That power is oftentimes, once you get the skill level the same, the power is all the difference.
Right, exactly.
Weisner is picking up the motion.
Well, Weisner got to get his head over to the left side if he's going to do that underhook. You can't underhook and have your head on top or the other side.
Oh, gave a spin.
Yes.
No points yet.
Watch your ankles. Keep on the right. Keep circling behind.
That's what he needs to get that other.
Yeah, Brown's going to look that dive through
Coach,
again.
Coach, bring the chair, please. Bring the chair.
I think at this point, he probably gets into a stalemate pretty soon.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, that's a 43 seconds.
Yeah. Great cable spin, but just didn't quite have the knees, both knees. Brown was able to get that, you know, right leg free.
Okay, so Brown does just go and not take a bad shot here, and all the pressure's on Garrison Weisner. Oh, nice single leg.
I gotta tell you, man, that Brown has got to have some kind of jelly in his cartilage or something, man, because he can turn all of his joints bent.
Oh, yeah.
He is flexible as all get out. And that's tough to wrestle against. I mean, you got somebody that could be, you're not used to it. You know, they're grabbing to try to be offensive when you've got really good position. That's tough.
Well, here we go. We're going into the third period now. Scores 9-3. Carson Brown from St. Ed's is up by 6. And let's see what Garrison Weisner does here to close that gap. Yep. Yeah, I like how he getting ready. He got his right leg in there. He done a really good job with his legs as far as blocking the ankle and, you know.
Oh, it could be a reversal here, Coach. Not two yet. That should, yeah, I agree with that. And then no control.
Oh.
No control lost. He's almost got to come up in the crotch on those because he's got stinking He's so funky
yeah.
with those long legs. You get down by the knee. Oh, man. I got to tell you, that's one of those examples I told you about that Jimmy Edwards taught me was give them an option. That's what happened there. My option was break my arm or give the two, and he gave the two.
So we're down 11-5 now.
50 seconds to go. Unless Weisner can come up with something significant. Six
you got,
points, so you got to get a pin at this point, right? And now it's a defensive pin. Maybe come up, grab that head, arch back.
30 seconds.
There, he came to it. Oh, good job by Brown. He kind of went, he felt that happening and got himself out. Gave up the two because he felt that half in already. 11-7 now, but it's only 15 seconds. So right now, Brown can stay away, right?
Well,
stalling,
see if Fioli's going partay and then he's front headlock. Nope. Head in the ribs. 5 seconds.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And,
pretty good bout there.
Shane Edwards as its first state champion this year. And Carson Brown, who's now a two-timer. So he's got a chance of being one of the special ones. Coach.
Yeah, he does.
Cole Evans from Perrysburg is going to be going against Phoenix Contos from Toledo Weight.
Well,
so these guys are both out of the Toledo area. I'm sure they've wrestled several times.
Yep.
This is Evans was state champion last year. I'm sorry, in 2022 at 106. Contos was second last year at 126.
Okay.
He wrestled in the district finals and Contos came out on top. So we'll see if Evans can avenge that loss or Contos can.
1-4 ranked.
Yeah, the rankings are right on with Bomb State, right? Contos ranked number one, Evans ranked number four. Evans is going to be in your gold singlet, black trim.
Are you guys twins?
No. Contos.
You must be a freshman then, right? Okay.
Contos in the all black singlet, Evans in the all gold singlet. We're going to wait for the girls' bout to get ready. And we're off.
Well, again, they're both pretty big 26-pounders, so watch his head and neck.
Great scramble. Great
That was good.
That should be two. Wow, that's big.
Wow,
80%,
big points. That's right.
80% of all matches are won by the person with the first takedown. That's a big takedown. We saw Contos last night, Coach, and he was rangy, long arms, real good in funky situations, but that was out funky.
Yeah, Cole's a little bit taller.
Another roll attempt by Contos, followed by Evans.
Oh, here we go. This could be
he locked those legs because he's got that arm trapped over there by Contos. This could be a good scoring situation for Evans. Hey. 55 seconds.
Yeah.
Period. So
Cole looks like about 3 inches taller, 3 or 4 inches taller.
That length, especially at 126, both of these guys are tall.
Yeah, they are.
It just can be tough for an opponent with that, especially at the lower weight classes. You're just not used to having that reach.
I like how Cole's blocking the ankle with his foot, right foot.
He picked that ankle, and now we got a better roll coming. We've seen Cantos do several roll attempts. Reaches across for the...
Another scramble, 24 seconds. That was smart. Give up one, not two.
We haven't given the one yet. Still controlled by Evans. Now you're at 10, 15. It's time to know where you're at and get out.
Whoa.
Still gotta get that leg in, 5 seconds. Wow, what a great
fight. Wow, that was.
He held that arm so tight to not allow him to get away.
Yep.
That was big.
Yep. So they don't defer. And Kontos takes down.
We'll see what happens. I mean, Evans did a great job riding.
Yeah, he did.
So, you gotta.
Yeah, there was a lot of action. And look at all the photographers on the other side of the mat. Awesome.
It's the fishbowl.
We might photobomb some of them. Look at that. See how he uses his right foot to block Kontos's top of his foot.
Get movement forward, right?
Yep. Look at that. That is really smart.
Now you got the one.
All right. Don't shoot there.
Shot from outside. Who's going to win the scramble? Evans won the first one. Can he win the... Again, he's turning around. Can he get it?
Whoa.
He's in good position.
Get your cradle.
Down to a minute two. Wrestling right on the edge.
Okay. 1 minute.
I think that's a little bit of a... Well, we got a cramp. 38 seconds left in the second period. It's 2-1.
Well, we got 56 seconds to go.
Keep your feet moving. Keep moving, son. Don't fight on the face. Hands go down.
All right, we're down blocking.
Well, we got 35 seconds. Long as...
Right. Obviously, these guys are so nice.
Oh, man, that was nice.
There. Boy, can he walk it around?
Look at that.
He picked that back ankle.
Yeah, that was smart.
You got 13 seconds. Can you score it here? Can either guy score it? You got the
split.
4 seconds. No time.
Oh.
All right, no point.
All right, so Cole's going to take down this time.
Let's see, he's going to try to get the escape and go back up by 2 points.
Yep.
We'll see what Kontos can do.
Oh, he gives them one on their feet. So
we start period 3-1 then.
That's big. Again, as long as Cole takes a good shot, he's in control of the match right now, being up by two. Puts all the pressure on Kontos.
Oh, Kontos putting the throw by. He's almost got
it. Uh-oh.
That
could be a standing Merkel.
Right. Oh, but Evans.
Oh, Evans.
Gets,
wow.
Now he's in position to score. He's going to go for the... If he could get the cradle because that head's so close. Swim over it.
Oh, man.
Stayed there a little longer, but... And I am impressed with Evans' scrambling ability. He's doing a great job.
Yeah, he is.
We got a question from the weight coaching staff. Not sure what he's asking about.
big upset victory over on the girls' mat.
Okay, don't know what that was all about, but
there wasn't much to really ask about there. I'm wondering, again, there's a lot of strategy that goes into coaching and all this kind of stuff. We got ear to ear. There's a duck under. Cantos did that to Huggy Williams a lot.
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
Evans is scrambling. So back into this scramble situation.
Look at that. Look how he's got that ankle. That is really interesting.
Oh, boy. Kanto stepped over that. Oh, boy. Headlock. No, but no back points to Cole. So
wow.
Cole Evans gets 2 points. He's up 5-1. Certain low time left. He can keep those legs
30
in.
Seconds.
30! All adjustments! All adjustments! All adjustments! No roll! No roll!
20 seconds! All right, so we've got really good coaching. We're from the corner.
Oh, yeah, that's big. 14 seconds.
14 seconds. We got good control by...
Come on, Coley.
He gets, he gets a couple of back points.
Belly out.
We get two on the reversal, but there was two back points. So I think we win the match 7-3. Cole Evans
is our state champion.
He avenges the loss and upsets the number one wrestler.
Yeah.
What a great match for both guys.
Well, I just got my... Okay.
All right, so we got Adam Butler from St. Ed's going against Marcus Blaze from Perrysburg. Perrysburg, Blaze, number one in the state ranked. He's a two-time returning state champion as a junior. So he's going for trying to keep history alive for him.
Yep.
Butler ranked sixth.
Where? I don't know where he's going.
He's a two-time placer. Both are, again, in black, all-black singlets. They have all-black shoes and all-black headgear. So Butler is in the gold trim with the green anklet, and Blaze in the all-black.
Yep,
with the red
both
anklet.
Have black shoes, so that doesn't help us. And I'm guessing they wrestled at the districts in the semis.
So far, Butler's come out really attacking. Butler's really come with a high energy.
Yeah.
A lot of pressure. Oh, Blaze comes around. Oh, beautiful job by Blaze. Got the ankle, followed.
All right, got a minute eight to go.
Where he beat the other opponent to the spot, right?
Yeah, so, oh yeah.
A lot of speed in this match. There it is again. Comes around, went for the... Boy, he's catching that far ankle.
Yeah, he is. He's doing a really, really good job.
Man, I'm loving what I see out of Marcus Blaze.
Yeah.
Because he's got multiple moves. He's trying one and knows when that's defended, the other moves there. And he's sequentially wrestling from one to the other to the other. That's what creates speed. And there, again, another takedown.
Yeah.
As Butler tried a head and arm attempt or a head wrench.
No, we got
6-2.
6-2 with 34 seconds. Well, St. Ed's sitting on his ankles. Butler sitting on his ankles. See what that does. Slowly coming out. Look how Blaze blocked that ankle with his right knee. It's really interesting.
Boy, this is the coach you talked about, that head lever and twisting that wrist, and Blaze was just doing that like you talked about.
right, go for a trip here. We have no loss of control yet.
All right, 62.
So now you go from the laces down to hooks.
So yeah, hooking the toes, and that used to be give you a drive off. I don't know if that's still the philosophy or not.
We see great wrestlers have different philosophies with them. Both these guys are great. One does one way, one does the other way.
Oh yeah,
it's just what you do, what you're.
All right. Well, Marcus got out there. That was a nice series. That took 20 seconds, and man, he is just fast.
Ankle, that.
Wow. So now we got 9-2. He lets him go, 9-3.
It's just so fast at those ankles.
Oh, yeah. It's amazing.
And that starts to get
easier.
He's got a cradle now.
That's right.
But it's. It starts to be part of why it starts. Oh, is he going to get it over? He does. Posts his head over there. Can he get him flat? I don't know. He might now. That's a big squeeze.
Wow, 55 seconds. Wow.
He sunk that hip and shoulder into that side once he got in. That was fantastic by Marcus Blaze. So. Now a three-time state champion.
Yeah, he is.
He's next year going to go for four.
What?
All right, coach.
Got two number ones from
138. Charles Curtis from Massillon Perry. He's in black singlet with gold trim on the legs. He's going to go against Kate Brown from St. Ed's. Also black singlet with gold trim on the legs. Curtis has the black shoes on. Brown has the white shoes on. Right. This is Charles Curtis is ranked number one in the state. Brown ranked number three in the state.
Well, we should have a good one here. Oh, that was nice.
Oh, man. We were talking about speed last match. These guys are super fast. That was lightning flurry.
Yep. Big strong, too, both of them.
These guys have placed the last 2 years.
Yeah, so it's.
Brown was in the finals last year, lost in the finals, took second at 132. Curtis took fifth at 138. An inside trip attempt by.
Yeah. Got 43 seconds in the first period. Very nice single.
Gotta come up and grab that knee. Gotta come above that knee and come up. Tries for this limp arm. Doesn't.
Oh, there's a cradle.
Face off.
Wow.
Man, that was.
That was a good flurry. 9 seconds to go.
I have a question on whether the Merkel should have been scored a takedown.
Yeah.
Because it is a pinning combination.
Yeah, right? Yeah. So, of course, if you don't straighten it out.
Yeah. So it's also a scramble situation, right?
Yeah,
so it's
that's right.
Defense. So that's what the official was explaining is, hey, it wasn't control.
We continue 3-2-1. And I'll tell you, we've had some matches in this tournament that have been slow, no score in the first period.
Then
this was no first score in the first period.
Yeah.
And it was not slow.
That's that wide.
Kind of a one of each ankle position, right? Worked well for Brown.
Whoa, that was.
Who's going to win the scramble? We've seen this a lot. Oh, that's Brown. Brown's got the two.
Yeah.
That's big. Three to nothing. And this is a tough. This is a really good position for Brown. If he can,
yeah, he's got that deep. Yeah.
Now Curtis has got a little bit better chance of defending it.
Right. So there you go.
Loading them up on your hips with that. Right?
Yeah, right.
So 3-1 now, so Curtis has got a score here. Oh man, nice high crotch coming up. When you come up, you gotta come up there. He got into the scramble again. He's got a scramble in his knee.
Seconds. His right knee got wrenched big. There you go. Back to his base. That was big, though.
That's 8-1 in favor of Brown. So what was
that?
Curtis has a fantastic high crotch, but he stays low and allows it. If he comes up and finishes high, comes across on that double leg, you don't allow that scramble situation to occur. What happens is, though, when you're as good as he is, you don't necessarily have to do that all year long.
Right.
Until you get to this opponent.
Right? Yeah. All right, well, it's 8-1 going in the last period. You got to get to his, you got to get to his feet and get out of there and then
get to work.
Now and again, you know, you got Cade Brown just needs not to make a mistake.
Yeah, you're up by 7 with 2 to go.
You know, you got that.
You got to keep wrestling hard, but you got to wrestle smart.
Right. Well, and, you know, again, if he doesn't come off the hips there, that's.
But really, at this point, Curtis has to, have urgency here. He's got to get out.
Yeah, I mean, that's, yeah.
Whether that's rolls, whether that's. So he found the spot to get up. Now he's got to stay strong with it. All right. 1 minute 13.
Now you got to finish, like you said, you got to finish that high crotch. You got a minute 4.
So with a minute to go, he's got to score a couple.
Oh,
well, that's rough. That honestly, that's kind of the way this match has been going. That could be.
Yeah, that's big now.
Right?
That's right.
You're down. You got to think about a sit out.
Yeah. You know, I used to say all the time, in order to get a pin, you got to want to get a pin, and the guy that you're pinning's got to want to get pinned. So that fits in with your Jim Edwards philosophy.
Well, sometimes you can catch them too, right? So.
Yeah. Well, we're down 18 seconds.
Brown has done just, he came out and from that first scramble series where he got it, he really just took control from there. Good try to throw, but just a little too late.
Yeah. Well,
and Cade Brown wins the state championship. He was second last year, but he's first this year.
Well, and that they only have two.
Coach, we move to 154. It's the Central Ohio weight class. Ryan Bennett from St. Edwards is going against Omar Ayub from Dublin Kaufman. Bennett is black singlet. Omar Ayub. A lightning strike, black with lightning.
And nice.
Again, I love the shoes.
The little gold stripes down the side. I like it.
Number one and Ayub versus number three and Ryan Bennett. Both these guys have been state champions. Ayub, two-time returning, took second as a freshman. Bennett won it as a freshman. Has been fourth and second the last 2 years. Could be the match of the night.
Yeah, let's hope it is.
The square.
Shot, scramble.
Get your foot in the mat. Come on, elevate!
Come on. Boy, I like that.
Omar's so flexible at those situations, you know. That's the.
He's got that freestyle high cross.
Yeah.
Knees on the mat. Now work.
Like I said, you know, he very rarely panics. I've not seen Omar in any situation where he's just like.
Yeah, even here, he's in a.
Look to come through. Swing right arm. That's it. Put in the mat. Swing right arm.
Wow, now he comes up the other side with a chance to score himself.
Keep that ankle.
I would think sometime.
Into him.
Wow. I'll tell you what. That's the danger of not calling that sooner.
Right. That's what I was thinking.
Flurrying. And, you know, they were in that scenario for, you know, a whole minute.
Yeah.
Well, 30 seconds. And, you know, just too bad that you, I mean, you had a chance to hit that as a stalemate a lot sooner and not have this. This looks like this could be actually a serious situation. And you hope that it's not.
Well, we noticed that they've been banged up. He and Ethan Bird have been banged up the last 3 weeks of the season. And
it looks like it's going to be able to continue, so. Oh, he's got that knee is pretty well braced up.
So yeah.
He may have an earlier injury on that one to begin with. So, we start again.
Well, we talk about the wrestlers, but I'm going to tell you, the referee, I am pretty jealous of the hair that the mat judge has on here.
Yeah, we call that flow.
Flow, okay.
So he's got some lettuce, some flow going.
I like it. I like it. Well, we're down to 30 seconds here, and he must not have got the memo that mullets went out in the 80s.
Well, they haven't.
I wouldn't know, John. I wouldn't know. You know, my style is early Benedictine monk style.
Hands ready.
Well, we're down to 5 seconds.
All right, great.
Interesting, interesting first period. All right, so Ryan Bennett takes down. And Omar Ayub, see what happens here on top.
He goes right to the head lever.
Again, look at the right knee blocking that. Whoa, nice lift. And
again, you've got Bennett looking for those rolls each time.
Yeah.
Be ready right away.
Nice.
All right,
so.
1-0 in favor of Bennett's first score in the match.
Got a minute and a half here. Let's see what happens. It looks like Ryan Bennett is not letting up, you know, coming after Omar.
Scoring three, run, 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 run. Tracy got it. Short and run.
All right, got it. See, now, I don't know. I'd be on that elbow. With that, but,
oh, boy.
Yeah, well, they knew that was coming.
Shorten that elbow.
So now Omar's head's down, and you know how I feel. Body goes where the head goes. And again, I don't know, get on that, both arms on, hands on that elbow and try and shuck it by, but.
It's tough. Tough shuck for Bennett if he doesn't. He's pulling back so hard on that.
Well, he's got that chin,
yeah,
too.
Yeah. He's got his underhook on the far side to try to get over. You really want to be, if you're putting that head in the hole, you got to slide your, get that chin instead of being tucked under there because you're preventing yourself from getting around. I think they were mostly not getting scored on it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 33 seconds here.
Good.
One of those matches, Coach, where, you know, first takedown,
yeah,
is likely going to be, will win it, right?
Yep. 18 seconds.
Pull the elbow out.
And again, I don't know, the hand on that chin, I don't know if that's a, should have called stalemate a long time ago. Let her up.
At some point, right? I mean, you get the choice. So do you let it go or do you want him wrestling or whatever? So he's been consistent.
All right, so here we go. Last period scores 1 for Ryan Bennett and 0 for Omar Ayoub. And
no real initial move either way. Bennett puts a half in.
That's it.
He's got a nice half end, but yeah, he peeled it off.
Well, that's why those rolls scare me with a half end.
Right, he's getting almost out. Bennett does a good job catching the leg.
Well,
keep it.
That was interesting. Working on that bad knee. 105.
Situation that you and Keegan differ
on philosophy. That's right.
Well, the issue is, it depends on what you have, because I don't know that he was really picking which leg he cracked on that one. It just happened to be the one he had to.
Back point.
I'll tell you, Bennett has done a great job.
Yeah, he's a lighter.
Defending the escape.
Yeah.
He's done a great job of, you know, trying to make a turn. He's done a great job riding and defending the escape, right? So 49 seconds. Ayoub needs to pick up the pace here and set.
Yeah. Yep.
Now we're in scramble. Who's going to win the scramble?
40 seconds.
Yeah, I'm not sure I agree with the end point of, anyway. 35 seconds to go. So Ayoub's got it. Boy, he's just not getting that. I don't understand. There's no real movement from below.
No, it's very uncharacteristic of what we've seen all year.
Keep it.
Tomahawk.
Keep it.
How's that not stalling? You got 3, 2, 1. Wow. It was a great job,
yeah,
by Bennett, of really not doing much of anything. Almost stalls his way to a championship, but hey, that's a strategy, and he got the right official for it to work on. So,
yeah.
Great job.
That's
All right, Coach, 150.
Yep.
Jackson Truly from Wadsworth in your black singlet, red trim, going against London Murphy from Archbishop Bowler out of Cincinnati.
Yep.
He's in your gold singlet with a blue trim. Both of these guys are
number one, Mr. Champion.
Yeah, Wadsworth Joy is ranked number one in the state. Murphy number two, so.
Well, looks like we're in for a good one.
Joy, two-time state champ. Took second as a freshman, so he's been in this match every year that he's been in high school.
Whoa, that was quick. That was quick.
Quick takedown.
Yep, 7 seconds. Yeah, coach is yelling, cut him. So that was, you know, my philosophy on that.
Wow, man. He's got great bat presence.
Yeah.
That shot. He feels the pressure and just put, you know.
Yeah, it's like, why would you even waste time riding him?
Well, put yourself in potential situations, right?
Look at that.
Now he's got a position to come up for two, for stay between those legs.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I like this. Like this, he may roll through it. But can we see it? Yeah, two-time state champion rolls through from his back to get the back points, coach.
Ah,
it's impressive. I know you love that.
1 minute. Yeah, you got a minute to go. It's 9-3. So you can tell these guys wrestle a lot of freestyle.
All right, two more points for Jackson Joy. 11-3.
Off your butt! Off your butt! Off your butt! Hips up! Hips up!
All right, you got 23 seconds, and
right now he looks like he's going to hold on to try to get a restart, or.
Three, two, one. That's all she wrote. 11-3 gone in the second period.
So Jackson, so Joy gets the choice. He takes neutral. Why not, right?
Yeah, really. I mean, it's been, yep. You got to give Loud Murphy some credit, though. He's not giving up, or London Murphy.
All right, scramble. Situations.
Push the curve.
Murphy's squeezing that head with his pretty well. Oh,
yep.
Lets it get popped out. Joy pops it out. He's got. Just keeping that.
Yeah.
Got the Navy ride. You're up by 10.
Watch the roll. Watch the roll.
Minute 10.
So Joy's trying to get, he's trying to get back points here. It's gonna be tough. But he's, there he goes. He's kicking him. You're well over halfway through. Oh, man.
Oh, almost a nice ankle picket. Yep. I think Jackson Joy is just about done. Oh, my goodness.
I tell you, Murphy did a great job scrambling to not get taken down on that last
one. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Well,
Murphy gets his first offensive points in the game. 13-6 going into the third. Well, he's not done yet. He's thinking, hey, I'm going to try to pin him. So he takes the top position.
I don't know.
All right, gets a leg in. Got to go cross body. Yep, there you go. Got cross body.
Oh,
now
double
he
jam. Power half, double jam.
Got to shake him off. If you're Joy, you got to get that power half in and break him down. If you're Murphy.
Minute 34, 13-6, and
good first move by
Joy. Yeah.
Oh, he does it, Granby. Out of bounds. Does that inbounds, he's going to score. Get his escape.
Oh, yeah.
That
uh-oh.
Banana split. Oh, yeah.
Come on, 1 minute, bud.
1:14 to go, and
he needs the guillotine.
The old guillotine, yep.
Or the spladle, that's another one that he could do. Let him in on his leg and hit the spladle. That's from the way back machine.
That was from the way, way back machine.
Oh, wow. Can he catch? And almost had. Tell you.
What a turn of events this has been.
Joy. Now he's going to the optional start.
Front headlock, watch.
Going for the throw. Oh, good job by Joy getting the single leg there.
That's a reversal. He's on his back. Two. No roll, kid. No roll. Come back in.
So now we got 15-6 with 13 seconds to go.
Yeah, Joey did a nice job of.
Good job, bud.
Joey's doing a good job. He's got 9 seconds to go. He's got a small call, but he's got plenty of time to. There are plenty of points to give up.
That's right.
At this point, I don't know. I think I kick him.
He got the memo from you.
4-3-2. Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good sportsmanship, I tell you. You don't see that often. From London Murphy. Great job by Jackson Joy.
Excellent.
Has dominated the match.
Tyler Derrick.
We got Tyler Derrick from Powell Olympiad Liberty. He's going against Eugene Harney from Sycamore.
Harney had an interesting match yesterday when we saw him. Remember, he pulled it out there right at the end.
Yeah, he did. So he's a returning state champ at 150 last year. Derrick's 34-8. He breaks sixth in the state. He's having a hell of a tournament. Saw yesterday in the semis, Harney super fast out of the gate, and then
the
other wrestler caught up to him.
Right,
kind of shut down. Maybe
had
like a momentum stall.
The gas. It's like having a big V8 engine, you know. good in the quarter, not good on a trip.
Yeah.
Derrick's has been interesting all the times we've seen him. You know, nothing really flashy, just very solid.
Slide. Get that toe down.
All right, good defense there. All right, grabs. All right, so Hardy gets the first two of the match.
Yep, a minute to go.
Again, he did that in his semifinal match as well.
Yeah, he did.
And then had to come in the last second score to win because, again, like you said, he got out the lead and then, allowed a comeback. So, Derrick's certainly in the match. It's early. He gave up a two, but he's got to just focus on getting that first score. Carney's got that cross body now. Don't do too much with it.
Forward!
Really strong there. Oh, yeah, I like the call. I wasn't sure until he pointed.
Yeah.
He was hanging on that ankle while he was doing it. That's he wasn't trying to improve, so.
Well, we got 28 seconds, so Tyler needs to hit something quick here.
Yeah, that one point, as we talked about, getting that escape after you've been taken down in the first period is big.
Yeah.
And firstly,
you got that bar in there. Makes me wonder about Harney. He looks at the clock constantly. I don't know if it's just to know, what time he's got to do things. Notice he just looked again. All right, so Eugene Harney takes down, and Tyler Derrick's is on top.
Oh, he goes for the hammer lock or the head lever. Harney did a nice job just posting that elbow and spinning to it.
Right. What I've liked about Tyler, all the matches that we've seen with him, he doesn't come out of the center. He doesn't come out of that circle.
Right. It's important for him to get the next points.
Yeah.
Just from a momentum standpoint, he doesn't have to go after it and put himself in jeopardy to do it. Got plenty of time in the match, but and you're right, Coach. He's always had that fluid motion too. That he's stalling. He's a talented wrestler.
He's solid. He doesn't make a whole lot of mistakes. And like I said, what I like, he defends the circle. I don't know if, I don't know how much they watched Eugene Harney wrestle, because I would think they would want to put
the pace.
Yeah.
Stay on him.
We got 28 seconds.
You're right. Harney is constantly looking at the clock. They're getting a scramble situation here. Yeah. Yeah, good call on the out of bounds because, he's trying to get, Derrick was trying to get out of bounds. Harney just caught him before he could get out.
All right, here we are. We've got third period. So Tyler takes down, and Eugene's on top. And we'll see if the pace picks up here in the third period.
Pretty good move by Derricks to start with. That's a switch. Gotta keep going. Gotta keep.
Good height. Good height.
Let's see if his stalling call comes again because he's staying down on that ankle still.
Height attack. Pick that up. Up, up. Up, up, up.
Oh, we gotta. Oh, it could be. It could be. He come back for it. He's got to come back. Yeah, he's
got a lot of time too. Got a lot of time.
On his head, yes.
Yeah, cross these, break that tie. Got a big high leg over.
Yeah. Pop that elbow.
There it goes. Using a lot of time.
You have 56 seconds.
1 minute. Hey, hey. Russell, Russell, Russell.
43 seconds. You gotta kind of.
I don't
know. That's it. Gotta keep moving. Create space and move. Up. Oh. Arnie's doing what he needs to do. He's just right.
Yeah.
He knows he's got a stall, but he can give up a point or two. The stall, he did. He steps over it. He don't quite have it yet. 3, 2, 1. Wow. Arnie dug out a tough one too.
Yeah, he did.
Champs. Well. And you're that good, you can learn that and you have a place to do it. That was one of the things. I wasn't that good. I could do that, standing backflip, but I never did anything worthwhile to do it in front of anybody.
Yeah, well, I would have landed on my head.
Yeah, well, we come to 165. Landon Johnson from Maslin Perry in the black singlet with a gold trim. And he's going against Ethan Burden from Dublin Kaufman. And he is going to be in the black shorts and t-shirt.
But
with the gold.
The purple series, buddy.
He's got the. All right, so you got.
Johnson and.
Ethan Burden. Burden is number one in the state coming into the tournament. Johnson's ranked seventh.
All right.
So Johnson gets set, gets his mind right, and we're off.
Again, Landon Johnson's pretty lanky and got that, looks like the same kind of build that Ethan does.
Oh, man. They start in a scramble like we did. Oh, he's got the cradle. Johnson felt that and got out quick.
Smart on his part.
Bearden has been so good with the cradles and so good with those low singles, right? So we'll see if he doesn't make him work and get him a cut here. Oh, no. Oh, boy. I didn't like that.
He rolled through. There's only to be dinner roll.
Oh, he did it. But he's stepping over back him. Oh, man.
That's why you don't roll through, right, coach? So it's 2-2. And boy, the challenge in this too, coach, is for Burden, he's given a lot of momentum back with that, right? I mean, he had control. He didn't need it. He could have cut him and gone takedowns. And now Johnson's, you know, not that he wasn't believing before, but he's in it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 2-2, and you got 21 seconds, so.
Vince, check your mic. See if it got turned off.
All right, starts. It'd be big. Burden's got to try to get out. Johnson's got to try to keep him.
Well, I think it's a perfect place to be right now. All right, so 7 seconds. Let's see what Ethan does on.
Oh, caution on. Yep.
All right, so if I was Landon, I would be expecting that
inside move, right? Exactly.
Unless he did it on purpose.
Nope.
Comes up. Go for the lift. And we're. Oh, man, that was huge. With 2 seconds left, he hits the Gramby. That was big. All right, so Burden takes down again. So he just got out for the one. Johnson was doing a good job riding.
I think I would have deferred myself, you know. You wouldn't get to this point. You know, you give the advantage to the other person.
All right, now Burden, that's 2 escapes in a row. I understand what you're saying, Coach, because then in the third period, you're potentially giving up a point already, so that puts more pressure on you in this period to score again.
He's got Landon's head on the other side of the, you know, he's controlling the wrist. He's got that underhook, but his head's on the wrong side.
And that's Burden's game is that speed, right? So he's one side, then the other side.
Keep moving with
them. Well, I thought I'd see a reach out there, but
you know, looks at head really well. You know, he'll post on the head, which is really interesting. I've not seen that very often. He likes to control that wrist too, so that stops Landon from, you know, take some of the dolphins away.
Right, there's that shot attempt. But that one was a high crotch attempt versus that outside single. Bearden has been the aggressor. So Johnson is, well, there's a shot attempt by Johnson. It's a good one. Both guys are quick.
Yeah, they are. It's really a good match. You know, a lot of scoring is almost as fun as, you know, close fight. Again, you know, you've got some tens on the wrong side. You're going, you know.
All right. So we go into the third. Yeah.
So he gave, you know, so now.
Johnson's going to take down, so. You got to figure he's going to get the escape. And you're 4-2 going in the period. You give up the escape, it's 4-3. No start. No real motion on the start pay for either wrestler.
It's interesting.
I got to believe that Burden's learned a lesson on that roll through, right?
You would hope. I mean, that's.
Oh, man, that's a good switch attempt. Johnson almost had that switch.
You know, again, so there's, you know, how much Burden's elbow, you know, that right elbow's missing the last 3 weeks. So
But right now you're getting that armbar series. You want to get the tilt, but load them on your hips instead of rolling through to get it, right?
You know how I feel about rolls, and that just, that almost.
Yeah, well, I gave up the 2 points, could have got pinned, right?
Right.
So that.
Right.
That's the danger. We've seen them go well, but when they go bad, they go real bad.
Well, you know, you take those points away, you know, take that away, it's 4-0.
Yeah, right. Or at least a 3-0, you wouldn't have the one escape, but yeah, you're absolutely right. And there's that elbow, right? You're right.
Johnson's going to be back next year. He's only a junior.
All right, switch attempt again. There goes again. Burden counters it by stepping into it. Big lift.
And again, I think I keep switching on Eric's right arm.
Yeah, for sure, because that's what. All right, so we got stall on both athletes. Now that's the right call here. So I think you ride until it becomes a place where he's about out, and then you give it. Oh, man. There's his one. It's 23 seconds left. So at this point, I think you just take some shot attempts here if you're... Oh man, good circle by Burden. That circle got, I think that circle.
Well, we got
one. We got 1 second.
Go for it.
You got 1 second.
Forward.
All right, clock's not right. They got to put 1 second on. And they do. And then here we go. And there we go. Ethan Burden is a two-time state champion as he goes on to Ohio State.
Yep.
And Landon Johnson gave him everything he could handle in that one. I mean, he had been dominating everybody up until this, but Johnson took it to him. But Ethan. All right, we'll move to 175. It's going to be a good one. Number one versus number two. Tyler Miller from St. Ed's is ranked number one. Carson Thomas from Cincinnati LaSalle is ranked number two. Miller going to be again in your all-black singlet. And Thomas, they're going to be in your white and red with red trim. Thomas was second at 165 last year, and Miller was third at 165 last year.
Good time, Miller. And Steve moving right away. Snap and run.
We had LaSalle last night. That was an interesting match with Carson.
Guys, get that motion going. Fake the snap. That's a
gravel. Yeah, so again, we've got the wrestling from the knees, which is, I'm guessing, trying to take away the offense of the opponent. And a piece on that, coach, that we talked about last night, well, there's some offense off of it, so I'm okay with that. But it's not really counter wrestling either, right? Because
it's more of you put yourself in a position to be snapped down and bowled over.
Well, Matt, you could be really good at defending the front headlock and getting a lot of, you know, drags out of that and stuff, so you're kind of hoping guys will get you in it. But if that's on film, that's the last thing I would do is get a front headlock on, right? So,
well, I don't know what Tyrell's trying to do. His head's on the wrong side, Mike.
So we're seeing, I guess, with a lot of these underhooks and their heads on the other side, they're trying to keep that underhook and get that far ankle. I guess when you're a longer athlete, you can do that, but it just feels like you're blocking yourself on those attempts.
Right.
Keeping that underhook on the other side.
It's the old axiom that I believe in. You know, your body goes where your head goes.
Hey, work hard here. Work hard here.
All right, so Thomas chooses down. We get the freestyle start. Oh,
wow! That's what he was looking for. Wow, he's going to squeeze if he can lift that head more. Keep him in. And he's got to keep him in bounds. Man, that was huge. Oh, man.
Wow.
He just caught him in that and put him right to his back.
So what do I know, being on your knees like that, right? They're in a power position because when you're on that knee, your hip's already in that throw motion. So Carson Thomas, that's a lot of points.
Yeah.
In this match, right? You're a minute 26 to go in the second. But Thomas now up 6-0.
One right away, guys. No time to wait.
We've got to get one at a time, so. Well, it's not like there was 20 seconds left to go in the year.
Right, right.
So you got a lot of time, and try not to get anything big, but just get one, two, and five.
Oh, now Miller gets this reversal. So that's big. Takes it to not being that much.
Yeah, looks like calling off.
You went from 6-0 to 6-2. Yeah, you also have.
Yeah.
And that registers back in that official's mind, right, of what's happening, right?
I mean,
so.
That was pretty blatant.
Well, that was the maneuver to try to escape, coach, is that you got to get your legs away. All right, so Thomas gets up.
One at a time.
Gets his one.
All right, so 7-2.
And Thomas gets that hook in again.
Yeah.
Get that hook. No.
You got to get out of there a bit.
Yeah, I'll tell you, Thomas is going to get hit for stalling if he does that too many more, because he's kind of sliding right to the edge of the mat and then gets pushed out, because on those knees, it's hard. You can't circle in when you're on your knee like that, right? So.
No.
Oh, so We got hands into the eyes, right?
Yeah.
And they didn't consider that incidental. They got that as a penalty point. So that's 8-2 now in favor of Thomas. That's one. All right. So it's 8-2. So that 6-point advantage is still there because of the escape and because of the penalty point. So the kind of negated that reversal. Miller takes down. But again, then we got a reversal in the last period, and it really closes the score up. And
well, there we go. Got 8-3 now.
Now a 5-point move ties you, so you got to have that. But you don't need it right away. Minute 40, you can still score. Now at this point, so he gets him to going to the edge, which I would agree with that. But now he gets in deep, getting a scramble. It's going to get him either a score or probably 15 seconds of time. And he kind of try to roll back to the head. He's working up. Probably elevate to, if you elevate to his back. There, that's the scoop. Now that's your two. That's 10-3 with 45 seconds to go.
There you are. Todd, 34 seconds. Get to your feet. You got to go.
I think that was just a restart. I was good either way because you could have hit him with a not a stalling, but a stalemate on that too. So he just said out of bounds. I'd have been better with a stalemate, but I'm good either way. They needed a restart, so.
Put in the mat.
30 seconds. Now, if you're Thomas, you don't do anything. You take a stalling call, that's fine.
Yeah. I mean,
you got plenty of points, but don't put yourself in jeopardy.
Go.
And Miller's got to get out, got to hit a roll, got something.
Saw what a mistake would do. You know, again, I think that's stalling there too. You pinch the ankle like that, you're not trying to improve your position, but.
Yeah, 5 seconds to go. 3-2-1. And Thomas wins the state championship. He was second last year as a sophomore. So as a junior, he's a state champ. Nicely done. That throw was,
That was big.
That reminded me of Mr. Dealey. He would have yelled and screamed and jumped up and down. We get treated to the next match in a row, 190, Coach, with one against two again. As you said, Matt Kowalski from Spring Grove in the white and blue singlet going against Jarrell Miller from St. Ed's. Miller, ranked number one in the state. He's going against Kowalski, who's ranked number two in the state. Both juniors. Kowalski has 45 wins, 4 losses. Miller's got 35 wins, 3 losses. Now we're started. We're off. Oh, man, that was slick. You see how he pulled him to him and then slid right by him. That was nice. Oh, he gave no points.
Big 190.
Not sure how that wasn't points. Wow. I'm baffled at that one, Coach. Can you tell me how that was not control? I don't know. All right, well, it's 0-0. We couldn't see the backside, so I'm not sure if there was a hand that was inside the leg or something. Who knows? I don't have the perfect view of it, but
to go on in that first shot. We have not a whole lot of action going on here.
Yeah, I think that may have gotten the caution back in him a little bit, right? So.
We got 30. Let's score.
Oh, wow. There we had that front headlock with the underhook. Could see Mitt mix that, right? I'm just throwing out all the old terminology, Coach. Oh, that's it. Got to went under. Man, I like that.
Yeah.
You got somebody with that overhook, or, you know, like that over your head, that duck under, that, you know, get your hips under, get your head up. Like it a lot. All right. Kowalski takes down. Big switch attempt. Gets him out for his one.
All right, so that lost his first offensive point.
Oh, man.
Oh, that was sweet.
Ah, I tell you, Kowalski's just really good with his hips. So that was a nice position for Miller. Kowalski just slid out of it. So we got Stalin on Kowalski for going out of bounds.
That should be green.
Oh man, shot attempt and he got it. That's 2 points. Oh, we got injury. Ankle.
That was interesting.
I'm not hearing you at all.
That was interesting.
Oh, we're on the same channel. That would be good. We should be good now, right?
What are you on, one?
I'm on one.
I'm on now. Two.
Okay, so we should be good.
Now, is it sound good okay?
Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, we got the, somehow we got our things crossed. I think when I put them in his pocket, sometimes they...
Yeah, that's why I took it out.
Yeah, we're not up off the ground and stuff.
I'm loving those shoes, Coach. Look at that.
Yeah.
That old fit is good. I like it.
Yeah, well,
I'll
tell you what. Old Matt Kowalski got some nice-looking shoes there, too.
They match up well.
Uh-oh. There's one of a Westland High School move.
Three-quarter Nelson, but it's still huffed. It's so hard to actually get, you know? I mean, you got to be a lot stronger than the other guy.
That's what he needs to do. Post that outside leg and get us free.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Oh, that's going to be tight. Yeah, that was good.
It's important for the missed period. 3-1 now in favor of Kowalski.
We got 25 seconds. Jarrell Miller needs to hit some offense. Down to 18.
Any points here, it's huge. Guess it was a 2 seconds, yeah.
All right, so here we are in third period, and Jarrell Miller takes down, and Matt Kowalski's on top.
Yeah, Miller gets escape and takedown. He's up by one late in the match, right? So we got blood going on Miller.
Right up here. Right side.
Yeah, good job by the other referee to get that ball cleared up. All right, so we got the cradle attempt going by Kowalski. Does he get it locked? He does have it locked now. He's got to roll through.
It's
tough on this one because you got it locked up.
Yeah, well.
Do you get back? Do you go over?
I
to get into his back out of this.
I know. I didn't understand why not to the head and the ribs, and why lock it up with your leg, you know?
Drop, drop. It's a one. It's a one. Kick, kick, kick.
He's got to come up.
going to get hit for stalling again because of the team rule, right? Then the other opponent gets to choose where you, and he chose down with Kowalski. Big toss on that freestyle hip move. Lift. Kowalski's got 4-1. Oh, nice. Man, nice high crotch attempt, but even better defense.
Yeah, it's 51 seconds.
I like what the coach said. You got one guy wrestling. I agree with him. Kowalski's about to get hit and stalling. Oh! That was it. Sometimes you can feel that your opponent stalling, and he really was, and you think, oh, he's not going to do anything. All of a sudden, bam, he hits a move on
him. Hey, you lost that.
What happened here?
Got that cradle up.
He's got that cradle, and it's on. Well, he actually doesn't have it locked. 20 seconds to go, 6-1. Kowalski, can stall. Well, now he's got a power half, so that's not going to be a stalling. Because he's trying to get a. Now he's on that ankle.
5 seconds.
4 seconds, it doesn't matter. Oh, wow. At Kowalski.
Yep.
Is your champion.
That ends the 2023-2024 season. We had two upsets, but for the most part, it was an exciting and good tournament.
Absolutely. As we always get, great wrestling at the state championships. We had three of our Central Ohio guys get into the finals. Ethan Burden took away the one championship. The other two came up a little bit short, but showed well. So we had a great tournament. Always good to be down here. And all these champions crowned are getting ready to get all their awards.
Their awards, okay.
Hi, this is Bridget with Matside TV. Don't forget to watch and follow us on Matside YouTube TV. Yes.
The year was 1907. The Cubs won the World Series and the Ford Model R hit the assembly line. While here in Ohio, school administrators came together to form the Ohio High School Athletic Association. One thing that hasn't changed since 1907 is the dedication of the OHSAA to education-based athletics in Ohio. School sports teach responsibility, sportsmanship, and life lessons that stay with students long after their playing days are over. The OHSAA seeks to prepare students not for the next level of sport, but for the next level of life.